Here we are with Blood Quartet. Welcome, benvingut. Well, we have here Mark Cunningham and the members of Murna OB, Quique Vela, Lluís Rueda y Candid Coy. How are you?
Fine. Very good.
And we are very happy to have you here right after releasing your first album, which is called Dark Energy. Very appealing title. And how is it going with the presentation so far?
Well, it's next Thursday is the presentation, so it's going to go well.
Okay. We hear and we saw that you had some interesting visitors during the Primavera Sound because you were kind of releasing your album in cassette.
And
I'm talking about Thurston Moore. Is there any
you'll have to direct to Mr. Ueda here. He takes all the Thurston Moore questions, please. Thank you.
Okay. Is any upcoming collaboration that you can talk about?
No, I don't know.
Thurston Moore is an old friend of mine. Okay. So, you know, I didn't want to go to Primavera Sound because I don't go anymore. But I sent Luis here.
So I did the job.
Because he's such a fan, you know.
Oh, yeah, right.
Well, no, I just wanted to give him the cassette because he talked to Mark previously about the record, the upcoming band of Mark. So they're all friends. And so we wanted to give him a couple of cassettes, just all.
Nice. So he's going to be your fan now, I guess, no?
I guess.
Right. So we want to start hearing your songs. Which are the songs you prepare for starting?
We're going to start with the first two songs from the album, which are Dragon Tree and String Theory.
Thank you.
So explain us a little bit about Blood Quartet origins. Who made the collaboration proposal to whom? How everything started?
It all comes from Ruben. He runs a magazine which is called Shookdown. And so our band Murnau were releasing a cassette in the magazine. So he thought that it could be a nice thing to join us together. Mm-hmm. In the show for releasing the magazine, and so this was, you know, the first, you know, so we made some rehearsals, you know, previously, but I was all free, you know, it meant all to be kind of free. So after the show, you know, it seems like we all enjoyed.
Yeah, and it came natural, no? Like.
And we loved Mark. We wanted to play with him, of course.
The most important thing is that this special issue of the magazine was about No Wave. That's why they contacted Mark, because it was about No Wave. So and we are trying to do some kind of No Wave influenced by bands like Mars and so. And that comes from the collaboration.
And I was happy to do something different. And it was just, the feeling was really good. We had no idea what we were, you know, about continuing it when we did it. But after, I was like, you know. And we started playing some more, and then we haven't done a concert since.
Huh? Oh, really?
We have not done a concert since. We have been preparing for how many months, guys? How many months?
Vaseline.
Yeah. Six?
Five, six
months.
So we're very lucky to have you here.
Yeah. And yeah, this is the first time we're playing in public, semi-public. Mm-hmm. Since then, yeah. So it's great for us, actually. Great. We're very happy.
Perfect. So we want to hear some more songs. Candy?
After these three people spoke about our band, I'm here a little bit trapped behind those glasses, you know, and with a camera just focusing me a lot of time, but I'm really grateful, but I don't agree in what you say, because I don't agree never in my life with anybody. So just play the third song and let's go. Visca Blood Quartet, hostia.
But why you don't agree? Candy.
Because I told you, because I never agree with anybody in my life, you know? So let's play the third song and...
Then swing
us,
homie.
Then you know that the drummers never talk.
Now we're going to play one song where I play guitar. It's the title song of the album, Dark Energy. Thank you.
you all come from different backgrounds, but at the end it seems like the experimentation is the point where you all converge. But in the other hand, it's like we are not allowed anymore to talk about experimental music nowadays. What do you think about?
Is that true?
I don't
know.
Not
allowed to talk about it anymore? Well, it's always been, you know, this catch-all term, you know. Yeah. Here in the States, they would just say underground, you know. And here it's experimental.
Yeah, but then it sounds sometimes as a cliche.
Absolutely. From the beginning.
Yeah.
From the beginning. But what can we do? This is what they always do.
And then talking about your creative process in the case of this band, can you explain us a little bit what do you do when you rehearse?
I would say it's basically we do improvisation. We wait for Candid first.
Candid, something to say?
Oh, I've been not able to understand your answer exactly. Can you repeat it, please?
Sure. No, but they say that quan quedeu per assajar, sempre t'esperen. Això és el que fan quan assajeu.
Ah, perquè el bo sempre es fa esperar.
Clar, això sí.
I ho faig completament expressament. També s'ha de tenir en compte que ells són de Barcelona, és de gent de Barcelona i jo visc a una hora d'aquí.
I'm not from Barcelona.
Llavors és més complicat. Però, bueno, a part d'això, ho faig una mica expressament, és veritat.
Basically, the process is that we... somebody has an idea and we improvise on it and turn it into a song. If it works, we turn it into a song. So we still have to think of develop a couple more for, you know, to be full, have a repertory, but it's getting there.
So now that's it. We have an idea, we work on it, we talk about, you know, I don't know.
Yeah. And then it's true that when you're playing, you create a kind of intense atmosphere. Is this atmosphere something you work on during...
We don't really need to work on it, no.
No, it just comes, yeah.
Well, I must say that there's one guru, four gurus, no? But that, we really... It's like, yeah, it's a crazy thing, but we... really speak about the songs the first time we played it, and maybe I don't speak very good English and I understand whatever I want, but we really speak about the songs and then we do, I don't know. So then this is the solution, but it really has a guide, I think.
Okay, so if you want, we can go now for the last song.
Okay.
Which one is that?
We're going to play two songs together, which are Gravity Pull. Gravity Pull and Rare Doom 7. We'll be right back.
So this was Blood Quartet for the music. Moltes gràcies per venir.
Gràcies a vosaltres.
Thank you.
A vosotros. Fantàstic. Thank you. It's a great opportunity.
Tot l'equip per suportar-nos, per estar aquí.
Thanks. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Muchas gracias.
And then how do we say goodbye?
Don't you want to repeat it? That last one?
No.
No?
No.
Because I would keep here 50 seconds more, you know, where we were?
Yeah, but it was
for me, yes, eh?
Yeah, but it's what it is.
It's what it is.
One takes.
Okay, no, vale.
El poble de Segurti.
Vale. Pues jo li hagués cardat 20 o 30 segons més, aquesta. Estava en un paradís que no m'havíem arribat.
No, it has to be short, this song.
Ah, okay.
Estàs fent versions per quan la gent surti a córrer, que es volia l'aigua.
No, però hem arribat a un paradís que no m'havíem arribat mai a la vida, eh? We arrived to a paradise, the last 20 seconds, we never arrived here with Bloodquart. We were in a paradise.
Yeah, yeah. We have to find that again.
That's why I would take 20 seconds more, but if you say it was enough, it
was enough. Remember, that was an improvisation in the studio.
No, we didn't make this
I didn't even know what was going on in that song.
My.
I had no idea.
Never.